afternoon and welcome to this short service of prayers, readings and reflections on life's pilgrim journey. We gather near the place that St. David found closeness with God, knowing God best as Christians have done through the ages, as Creator, Father, Redeeming Son and life-giving Holy Spirit. We pray we may also know God's closeness, his compassionate love and his wise direction in our lives. And so we begin with the collect, the special prayer for St. David, who called others to be joyful, to keep the faith, and to be faithful in the little things of life. And so let us pray. Our Father, you gave the people of Wales to uphold the faith. Encouraged by his example, may we joyfully hold fast to the things which lead to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honour and glory, now and forever. Amen. The scripture reading I've chosen for today comes from the lectionary for this morning. It's from Matthew 13, verses 24-31. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed ears, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. The servants asked him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" "No," he answered, "because while you are pulling the weeds, you may root up the wheat from them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, first, collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring into my barn." This is the word of the Lord. Derry's acre is looking rather barren at the moment. The vegetables are now finished, except the Swiss chard, which seems just to keep on giving. The weeds and plants have died back, and the greenhouse is currently empty and missing a window pane following the storm last week. Yet I know that within weeks, the first signs of life will again appear. The vegetable seeds will be sown, planted, the flowers will reappear, and life will again start teeming in there. One thing that I've learned this year as part of the gardening is that you should never be too quick to pull out the weeds, because they look just like the other things you've planted. For instance, this morning, whilst we were in the garden, I was busy pulling away some wild buttercup that was making its way across the garden, shoots everywhere, and some very similar plants looking quite like the buttercup were also in amongst the weeds. For me, this parable says far more than simply that there are good and bad things amongst the weeds. To me, the good and the bad look the same for quite some time, and only in God's time will we know which is which. Sometimes something that looks good can turn out to be bad, and even with the best intention, and vice versa, something with the worst intention can indeed turn out to be good. It is only in God's time that we will know which is which. As a weed grows, it may surprise you and turn into a beautiful flower. Nothing is lost until God says so. Nothing is lost until God says so. As we listen to our choral scholars singing the first psalm, let's spend a few moments thinking about those things that we can be faulty or wrong, let us consider that perhaps God has a plan.
Salvation, whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life, of whom then shall I be afraid?
When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell.
The host of men were laid against me, yet shall not my heart be afraid. And though there rose up war against me, yet will I put my trust in him.
One thing have I desired of the Lord, which will require, even that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the fair beauty of the Lord and to visit his temple.
Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in the right way because of mine enemies.
Deliver me not over into the will of mine adversaries, for there are false witnesses risen up against me, and such as speak wrong.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And so let us pray. We pray for ourselves and others who visit this cathedral today. Lord Jesus Christ, St. David's Saviour and Lord, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Be our way. Give us grace to follow your lead, courage to persevere when the going is tough, and when we stumble, let us not be afraid to take hold of your outstretched hand, as you offer us a fresh start. Be our truth. Give us your wisdom, so we may know how to walk in the paths of honesty and integrity. Be our life. Revive us when we falter, refresh us when we tire, and bring us to share in your risen life, now and for all eternity. Amen. Say together the prayer that Jesus taught us in the language of our choice. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Skies pour down righteousness.
joyfully follow you in singleness of heart. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you